Welcome to the second lab concept video in physical geography. In this video, we will discuss map interpretation. Understanding and interpreting maps is probably the most important skill that a geographer can have. Maps are the language of geography because geography is a spatial discipline. Understanding and interpreting maps is a key skill for this class. Whenever we look at a map, we should consider several key questions. I'm going to go over each of these with this example map. I encourage you to follow up by practicing with the maps in your atlas, as well as the thematic maps we will use in Lab 2. The first question we'll ask is this: what is the mapped area? In this case, we are looking at the continental United States with insets of Alaska and Hawaii. Next, let's consider what data is shown on the map. To figure this one out, the best place to start is the map title. In this case, we are looking at a map titled Average Temperature in Degrees Fahrenheit, December 9th to 15th, 2001. So the data that it is being depicted is surface temperature averaged over a week in December of 2001. Let's think for a minute about what surface temperature is. It is the long wave radiation released by the surface of the Earth. It results from the interaction of sun energy, or insolation, with surface materials. Okay, the next thing we want to do is examine the patterns that we see on the map. In this case, we are looking at a choropleth map, or a map where colors on the map equal specific values. Let's identify the coldest areas on the map by looking at the legend to confirm that the blues and purples are the colors that relate to the coldest areas. The warmest areas are represented by reds and oranges, so they are down here. Notice also that the temperatures display in order. In other words, there is a continuous set of values from the coldest regions to the warmest. You don't have a place that is 10 degrees next to one that is 70 degrees. Finally, notice that the temperature patterns do not align with latitude. The coldest parts of the country are in the western central region, while the warmest parts are in Florida and Georgia. Notice that as we answer these questions, we have made observations only. We are not interpreting the map yet. Next, let's ask some questions that will help us interpret the map. Let's consider what other factors may influence this data. First, let's observe what we do not see in this data. Recall that we have talked about the importance of incoming solar energy, or insolation, in driving all exogenic systems on Earth. So we know that the sun energy hits the Earth along lines of latitude, like this. The temperature patterns most definitely do not align with latitude, so there must be something else going on beyond just the incoming solar energy received. Recall from your examinations of maps in the USA that there are a series of mountains in this region. The Rockies. Perhaps areas that are higher in elevation are colder. Also recall that the Atlantic Ocean borders the continental US on the eastern coast, and the Pacific Ocean borders the western coast. Perhaps being next to the ocean has an influence on temperature. Speaking of the ocean, recall your observations from Lab 1 that the oceans off the east coast of the U.S. are warmer than the ocean off the west coast. Perhaps that has something to do with the fact that the land that borders the ocean off the east coast is warmer than the land that borders the ocean off the west coast. The final thing we ask ourselves when interpreting a map is this: how does this data affect other things? Consider all the things this map could have an influence on. Heating oil prices, cold weather gear stocked in stores, types of plants found in these locations, the first planting date for corn and wheat crops, and many, many others. I encourage you to try this thought process out on some of the other maps in your atlas. For example, consider the population density map found on page 48. Interpreting maps is probably the most important skill for a geographer to have. We will use these skills throughout the quarter, starting with Lab 2.